Good morning, students. A few topic has been left in this lesson, the story of village Palanpur. So today I am discussing some of the points. The first point is capital needed in farming. So as a modern farming method required a great deal of capital, the farmer needs more money for it. Small farmers has to borrow money to arrange the capital. They borrow from large farmers, village moneylenders or traders who supply various inputs for cultivation. The rate of such loans is very high. So they put into a great distress to repay the loan. Large and medium farmers have their own saving from farming. They are thus able to arrange for the capital needed. Now next, sale of surplus farm product. The large and medium farmers of Palanpur retain a part of produced grain for their own use and then surplus in the market. Trade in the market, buy these grain for selling them to the shopkeepers in cities and towns. So the farmers earn a good amount of money through this sale and keep them in the bank account. Later, they use the money to purchase input for the next farming section, purchase capital equipment or even give loan to small farmers. Some farmers also use the money to start activities in the non-farm sector. Their surplus money increases their capital as well as fixed capital. So now different non-farming activities in Palanpur. At present, only about 25% of working population in Palanpur has acquired non-agricultural occupation. It is almost similar to the percentage of non-farm working force in rural areas in the country. Though there is a variety of non-agricultural activity in the villages. For example, dairy farming, computer education, transportation, shopkeeping, the number of people employed in each activity is quite small. After farming, dairy is the most common activity in Palanpur. People fed their buffaloes of various kinds of grass, bajra grown in rainy season. The milk produced is sold and nearby in the village Raiganj. It has the collection cum chilling center by the two traders of Sahapur town and transport to milk to the far away towns and cities. Even in Palanpur, less than 50 people are engaged in manufacturing sector. It is done in a very small scale. Thus, manufacturing is carried out mostly at home in the field with the help of family labors. Labors are rarely here. A few people of Palanpur are involved in trading. It means exchanging of goods. The traders of Palanpur are shopkeepers who buy various goods from wholesale market in the cities and sell them in their villages. A few of the family whose houses are close to the bus stand have used a part of the spaces to open small shops and their eatable items. Now, the last point is transport sector. Even a number of vehicles run by the road that connect Palanpur to Raiganj. Many people are the transport services. Example, rickshawala, tongawala, jeep, tractors, truck drivers and people driving their traditional bullock cart. The number of people involved in transport has grown over the last several years. Now, I want to discuss some of these questions. One mark question. Now, let us. What are the main activity in the village of Palanpur? Answer is, the main economic activity in the village Palanpur is farming. Second question. What are the non-farming activities being carried out in Palanpur? Some of the non-farming activities being carried out in Palanpur are manufacturing, transport, shopkeeping and computer education. Next question, what are the four factors to production? The answer is land, labor, physical capital and human capital are the factor of production. Next question, which capital is known as working capital? Answer is capital that is used by the production like raw materials and cash in hand is known as working capital. Next, what is multiple cropping? Multiple cropping I am again repeating, what is multiple cropping? Answer is, multiple cropping means growing more than one crop on the same piece of land in a year. Now, what are the major advantages of HYV seeds in agriculture? Answer, the major advantage of using HYV seeds in agriculture was more production of crop in the same amount of land in one cropping session. Now next, what does HYV stands for? HYV stands for high yielding variety. Thank you.